thought it was a very hard-fought game by two teams. Amanda's done a great job with her group, and hats off to her. We had to battle, and she had to battle, and I guess if you're a spectator, it was an exciting game, but for the coaches, it was a little gut-wrenching. But we hit big free throws. We had two big stops at the end, and just proud of our kids for finishing the game. A horse. Yes.
Have you ever, in all your years, if you had any other time where the score was tied at 25 seconds, they gave the foul to send you on the line?
You know, I don't know. That's a good question. I'm just glad we went to the line.
Were you surprised by that rationale, that decision there?
What's that?
Were you surprised by Butler's
decision? It paid off for them. I mean, we made one. Is that the one we made one and missed one, correct? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's Amanda's decision. You know, I understand it, and that's part of her philosophy. And, you know, sometimes it's like fouling a three-point shooter before they get it. Do you foul them or not? So that was her decision, and she went with it. So,
Holly, how difficult was it in the first half with Izzy picking up two fouls and under?
You know, it was huge, and we talked about when we trapped the ball that if they got under us, to let them go. It was the main thing we worked on in practice. And it's tough. It puts us in a really difficult position when Izzy's out, and she sat out the whole first half, and then she's not in rhythm and coming in at the second half. So I was proud of how she battled, but we just can't let her – she can't put us in that situation. But, I, at one time we had Kamiko in at the four. We had Jasmine Jones, we had Tabor at the four, so we kind of mixed it up. But she gets one foul, she's got to be a lot smarter than she was today. But I thought she finished strong the second half in overtime.
With that in mind, how key was Bashara the whole game?
She was huge. She was huge. And I keep saying she's our workhorse. And she hit big free throws at the end. She hit tough free throws at the end, and she's a competitor. I know she kind of hurt her neck a little bit, but I knew she came out and just caught her breath a little bit. She would be back. So she's been solid. She's been consistent, and for a freshman to do that, and us to ride her back, that's huge. Very proud of her and how she's playing and how she's carrying herself.
Holly, what were you talking about down the stretch and in overtime? You haven't been in these situations very often. What were you stressing?
Well, we needed our biggest thing is get stops, get defensive stops. We have a drill called a persistence drill, and you can't come out off the D until you get a stop within 30 seconds and the clock runs. So it's a drill that's an extremely hard, competitive drill defensively. So we just talked about the persistence drill, getting stops, making stops, and getting the rebound. So that was key for us because at times the second half it didn't – I tried everything. I tried our zone. I tried to press. I tried man. We switched. We did a little bit of everything, but they were still able to get to the rim. So as we won, this is a great teaching tape for us to go back and to learn from.
Were you surprised that you were able to get those stops in down the stretch? You got the one at the end of regulation.
Yeah.
You got some in overtime.
Well, I've seen us. Dan, I've seen us how we play and how hard we play on defense. So I guess I was more surprised at our lack of intensity on the defensive end instead of our ability to get stops. It just we were looked a little bit disinterested in on the defensive end until light at the second half. So that's something that we preached at halftime about pretty strongly that we needed to. Step up and make plays on the defensive end. Because I thought the first half we were non-existent on defense.
How was Megan in the first half? Was Izzy out? What did Megan have, 17, I think, in the first half? How was she to get for the offense?
Well, Megan has the ability to stretch the defense, obviously, for the inside of the post. So I thought she hit big shots. The coaching staff and the players, every time Megan shoots and touches the ball, we think it's going in. So it's almost like when it doesn't go in, we're like, "Oh, are you kidding?" So Megan's always huge in our scheme of scoring the basketball in our offensive schemes as well.
Holly,
How big do you think it was for Florida to lose Jennifer George early in the game?
Yeah, I thought that was huge. I think what Bashard does for us, that George does for them. And she's physical, she's strong. I think she's a big-time player. And to lose her, I think it was huge. And my credit to them, it didn't seem to me that they let up. I think it would have been a great help for them if she'd have been in.
And did her leaving the game early affect your game plan at all?
I'm sorry?
And did her leaving early affect your game plan at
all? Not really. They came in and they were still going inside and scoring, so obviously it didn't affect her. It affected our game in a negative way.
Massingale, she's got to play a lot of minutes for you. How did she manage this game? Because she put in a lot in a tough position.
Well, I thought Ariel was, I didn't think she had one of her better games the first half, and then we challenged her and had a better the second half. And we had to sit her and rest her because, it was humid, it was hot, and I don't know what did she end up playing. I don't know, 42 minutes. So she's, with Andrea out, she's our leader. So we have to have her. And then a lot of times she's on their best offensive player. So we tried to get her off of Tien and Bonds and put Kamiko on her and put Megan on her a little bit because I thought it was wearing Ariel down a little bit. Yes.
Holly, you've had obviously a very good season. You've lost a couple of games. I haven't had a chance to see all those games. What in the games that you've lost, where would you say you've been deficient?
Well, I will tell you, the UTC game, we were scared. We were the first game out. And here's my biggest thing is if we play hard, we get hustle plays, and we play with a tremendous amount of effort, this team, great things happen to this team. And then in turn, if we're disciplined. So if we take care of those things, if our effort, if you're giving your best effort, we seem to be able to take care of things. I thought the Stanford game, you're going against one of the best teams in the country and you have no effort. You can't be average and play Stanford. You can't be average and play Baylor. Baylor, we were scared to death the first half. So it's a matter of getting up, being intense, and playing with a lot of energy, a lot of heart. And when you do that, this team thrives on getting defensive stops and scoring in transition. So when we get really lax and we're standing around, this team is not very good.
Holly, they pretty much, I think, had control of the rebounding staff.
Yeah.
How much does that make things more difficult?
Well, it is, because we hadn't been, I don't know off the top of my head how many, we hadn't been out rebounded in a long time. And I thought their offensive rebound, well, like at the end, we had a stop. They had a huge offensive rebound. So we really emphasize one shot. We hope it's a bad shot and get the rebound. And today I thought Florida did an awesome job on the boards, offensive boards, and gave them another possession. So that's another thing that we just continue, as a young team, we just continue to stress and continue to go back and work on. I guess that's why we have jobs and we haven't yet to play a 40-minute game, so.
You still happy though with the 4-0?
Oh my gosh, are you kidding? yeah, absolutely. Absolutely, I mean, I love this team. I love how hard they play and their response. I can, they're just extremely, extremely coachable. And when you get a team that wants to be coached and listens and play hard, you've got something special. And I think this group is playing extremely hard for the most part. And it's a special group. They're not a selfish group. They're okay with somebody out, Megan Simmons scoring 27 points, as long as we all play defense and play together. So it's a special group for us.